forgive my brother when he sins against me? Up to seven times? Jesus answered, I tell you, not seven times, but 77 times. Therefore, the kingdom of heaven is like a king. He said, the kingdom of heaven is like a king who wanted to settle accounts with his servants. As he began to settle them, a man who owed him 10,000 talents was brought to him. Since he was not able to pay the master board, that he and his wife and his children and all that he had be sold to repay the debt. The servant fell on his knees before him. Be patient with me, he begged. I will pay back everything. The servant's master took pity on him, canceled the debt, and let him go. But when that servant went out, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him 100 denarii. He grabbed him and began to choke him. Pay back what you owe me, he demanded. His fellow servant fell to his knees and begged him, be patient with me. I will pay you back. But he refused. Instead, he went off, had the man thrown into prison until he could pay the debt. When the other servants saw what had happened, they were greatly distressed and went and told their master everything that had happened. Then the master called the servant, you wicked servant, he said, I canceled all that debt of yours because you begged me to. Shouldn't you have had mercy on your fellow servant just as I had on you? In anger, his master turned him over to the jailers to be tortured until he should pay back all the owed. This is how my heavenly Father will treat each of you unless you forgive your brother from your heart. I have read this passage and I say to myself, or I did say to myself, really, Jesus? 77 times? That's how many times we should forgive. And he's actually not saying 77, he's saying definitely. Is what you forgive. That has been hard for me to comprehend sometimes. I have not always had an easy path of forgiveness for people. I grew up very poor. I went to school as a ragtag child and was treated miserably. Children to be cruel. And this day and time is called bullying. Back and when I was growing up, it was pretty much just left alone. You pretty much had to defend for yourself. So I've also heard it said that hell is on earth. I've heard some people say that. And as I was growing up, I thought to myself, if there is hell on earth, it's the house that I grew up. I know some of you have heard me say before, one of my earliest childhood memories is being slammed in the face with a full can of mold. And I've got a scar down from here to here. And you can see it, and I've carried it all my life. And makeup does a good job of covering it up, or sometimes when I frown, I know it's there. Not a big problem, but I know it's there. But you know, sometimes I think that scars in your heart, or on your heart, are harder to heal than the external scars. My father was on his deathbed, and he was on a ventilator in the hospital. And I remember telling him for the first time that I loved him, and I was in my 30s. And he had a tube down his throat, so he couldn't talk. But I remember him mouthing back to me, I love you. My father went to his grave, and I never heard those three words come from him to me, I love you. As I look back, I wish I'd said to him, I forgive you. But I'm not sure it's sincere, because I can't say that I was in my walk with my Lord at that time to forgive. And I think the more that you grow 37, he tells us to forgive and we will be forgiven. Forgiving someone doesn't mean that you condone their actions or what they did. I see it as a gift that I give, a gift that I get. I read a famous quote that says, "Unforgiveness, unchecked, becomes a cancer of the soul." Anger and unforgiveness towards someone is like poison. It can consume you. Someone once said that if you're holding a grudge, that grudge is really holding you. And I sincerely believe that. Forgiveness releases you. It takes a lot of energy to carry a grudge and stay angry with someone. And you know the sad part about it? A lot of times when we're angry and we're losing sleep and that person did this and we're expending all this energy, that person doesn't even know it. And sometimes they don't even care. So you've got to forgive and give it to God and let Him handle it. There was a Franciscan priest named Maximilian Kolbe. And he was sent to a death camp at Auschwitz in 1941. And a prisoner escaped from the camp. And the Nazis, the way they deterred, or they thought deterred prisoners from escaping, was if one escaped, 10 died. So a prisoner did escape. They chose 10 to kill. And as that happened, one of the men, crying out and said, "I will never see my wife again. I will never see my children." Well, Maximilian Kolbe, the priest, stepped up and he said, "I'm going to take his place. I'm going to die instead of him." And his request was granted. And he had been with these prisoners and as the way they killed them was they starved them to death. And so they put them in a cell, in a dungeon, in a basement. And when the people would come to, when the guards would come to empty the buckets of urine, most of the time there was none. Because it was drying, because these men had nothing, no food, no water. But and he asked them to forgive the persecutors. Most of them died, well, as a matter of fact, all of them died with him, and he was the last one. And he was taking too long because the Nazis needed this sale. And so they came in and they were going to inject him with carbolic acid. So they came into the cell. And when they came in, he lifted up his arm with prayer on his face, and they ejected him, and they killed him. Now this man had already forgiven. If he went through all that torture, and he forgave, can we not forgive? Acts 8:59 tells us that while Stephen was being stoned, he fell to his knees and he said, "Lord, do not hold this against him." And Saul was there given approval for the death. Okay. He could forgive, and we not forgive. I'm not saying that it's easy, and we may not have the spirit that Father Maximilian had, or that Stephen had, to just instantaneously forgive someone. Sometimes, I mean, it does take time and a lot of prayer, and I do think that we, and this is my opinion, our closest walk with God, prayer to the guilty. And I don't have time to get over that burden anymore. I learned and I learned the hard way. Just give it to the Lord. And sometimes it's hard to step up and take it back. But I don't want to be burdened with it. Give it to the Lord. And what I am saying is that if we say that we love the Lord, we can forgive because he tells us we have to, we need to. And he didn't say one time, what did he say? 77 times. We must pass on the forgiveness that Jesus has given us by shedding his blood on the cross for us. And as he hung there, he said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And he forgave him. And he shed his blood.